read the word, you study the word, and you go over, talk about what you just read and what it means to you and what you learn about it. Of course, we learn about Jesus, and that is the goal. That is, it's not about us. It's not about us. We are way too selfish. We are really, really selfish, and I feel like
ago, I came across a book
against eating.
placed him in the Garden of Eden.
he placed fruit. which I don't believe. I believe it's both parents, mainly the man, but really it's a partnership in everything. It's a team effort. So yeah, I feel like I don't even need to write these answers down if we just talk about it.
Chapter 3, verse 5.
strike your head. Oh my goodness. He will strike your head and you will strike his heel. That will cause hostility. I think that's what the action was. Okay, what's the next part? Read verse 20 and 25, I believe. 24. 20 to 24. 20 to 24. Then the man, Adam, named his wife Eve. He even named her. Of course, he named everything else. Because she would be the mother of all who live. And the Lord God made clothing from animal skins for Adam and his wife. Then the Lord God said, "Look, the human beings have become like us." I love when the Bible says that, like us, meaning Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, knowing both good and evil. But what if they reach out? I think this is the answer. What if they reach out, take fruit from the tree of life, and eat it? They will live forever. So the Lord God banished, that's what he did, them from the Garden of Eden, and he sent Adam out to cultivate the ground from which he had been made. After sending them out, the Lord God stationed mighty cherubim to the east of the Garden of Eden, and he placed a flaming sword that flashed back and forth to guard the way to the tree of life. Interesting. After sending them out, the Lord God stationed mighty cherubim to the east of the Garden of Eden, and he placed a flaming sword that flashed back and forth to guard the way to the tree of life. Interesting. So the question is, what do God's action following the first sin teach you about him? Snap, that's tricky. I think his action was to ban and to send the cherubim. What do God's actions following the first? It teaches me come on.